Good morning. My name is Mackenzie King, and it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to our annual African American History Program. On behalf of our principal, Dr. Donnell Mosley, and our entire William J. Clark family, we express sentiments of gratitude for your presence this day. Every February, people across the nation celebrate Black History Month with lectures, parades, award ceremonies, and numerous other events, all aimed at the preserving and highlighting of the immeasurable contributions of African Americans to U.S. history. But how much do you know about the origins of the celebration? I've gathered six important facts about Black History Month. 1. Black History Month began as a week-long celebration. 2. By the 1960s, Negro History Week, as it was formerly called, had largely evolved into a month-long celebration. 3. Black History Month was officially recognized in 1976. 4. Every year's celebration has a theme. This year's theme is the Black Family, Representation, Identity, and Diversity. 5. The observance isn't actually called Black History Month, but is actually called African American History Month since 1996, when President Bill Clinton issued Presidential Proclamation 6863. 6. The United States isn't the only country to celebrate Black history. Canada and the United Kingdom do also. Canada celebrates in February and the UK celebrates in October. With this in mind, we thank you again for your presence, and we hope that you enjoy our virtual program. Again, welcome.
Lift every voice and sing. Often referred to as the Black National Anthem in the United States, is a hymn written as a poem by James Weldon Johnson in the 1900s, and set to music by his brother, J. Rosemond Johnson, for the anniversary of Abraham Lincoln's birthday in 1905. The song is a prayer of thanksgiving for faithfulness and freedom, with imagery evoking the biblical exodus from slavery to the freedom of the Promised Land. It is featured in 39 different Christian hymnals and is sung in churches across North America. On July 2, 2020, the National Football League announced that the song would be played or performed live before the national anthem during the entry of Week 1 of the 2020 regular season. Most recently, February 7, 2021, the song was sung by Grammy Award winner Alicia Keys as part of the halftime show of Super Bowl. Please listen as our students perform a rendition of Lift Every Voice and Sing.
Harmony of liberty, Let our rejoicings rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the faith that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of a new day begun, let us march on till victory is won.
We shall overcome. A song that is the cornerstone of the civil rights movement. It is not a marching song, it is not a defiant song, rather it is a promise. We shall overcome someday, deep in my heart, I do believe. We Shall Overcome has been a civil rights song for over 50 years, heard not in just the United States, but in North Korea, in Beirut, in Tamina Square, in South Africa's Soweto Township. But We Shall Overcome began as a folk song, a work song. Slaves in the field would sing, I'll be all right someday, and it became known in the churches. A minister named Charles Albert Tingley published a version in 1901 titled I'll Overcome Someday. The first political use of We Shall Overcome came in Charleston, South Carolina, where there was a strike against the America Tobacco Company. The workers wanted a raise. They were making 45 cents an hour. They marched and sang together on the picket line. We will overcome and we will win our rights someday.
Plantation melody or work song is a piece of music closely connected to a form of work, either sung while conducting a task, usually to coordinate timing, or a song linked to a task which might be a connected narrative, descriptive, or protest song. One of my favorite plantation melodies is Peas in the Rice, Peas in the Rice. Peas and the rice, done, 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 done. Please listen as Madison Simpson performs an example of a work song, Sawmill Creek.
Mm-hmm. Elijah Rock, coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock, shout, shout. Elijah Rock, coming up, Lord. Elijah, 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 Elijah. Sing to the lyre and a conjure too. If you don't watch out, he'll conjure you. If I could, I surely would stand on the rock where Moses stood. Where Moses stood. Elijah Rock, shout, shout. Elijah Rock, coming up, Lord. Elijah Rock, shout, shout. Elijah Rock, coming up, Lord. Elijah, Elijah.
Change gon' come.